Hi guys, don't you love that card? So we're gonna make that card today. You're gonna need a piece of powdered pink paper. This is A2 size, so it's cut at 5.5 by 4.25. You're also going to need a piece of the silver foil. So this one here is cut at 2 by 4. So we're gonna run this through the Big Shot. You're gonna need your basket weave folder. If you haven't run the foil paper through this folder yet, you have to. It is amazing. It is so awesome the way it turns out. Look at that, guys. Look at how awesome that is. I love this folder. This folder is fantastic. So during Celebration, this basket weave folder is for free, along with the Blossoming Basket stamp set. These two are bundled together. When you spend $100, you will get this set for free. We're going to take Fresh Florals. This is the powder pink, and this one here is cut at 5.25 by 4, and this is just going to layer on top of your card. So now we're going to go ahead and take our basket weave strip of paper. We're going to take a piece of powder pink finely woven ribbon, and it's going to go right over the top of this. So what I like to do is just take some adhesive, or you can take a piece of tape, kind of just find your middle and then fold it to the front, and then we're just going to layer this right on the front of the card. So then what we're going to use is a piece of Whisper White. I'm just using a scrap piece here. And you're going to take, we're going to use the We Must Celebrate stamp set. So you're going to take the animals out of here. All I want to do is stamp out this bunny. I don't want to stamp out the rest of them here. You can cut it if you want. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to take a sticky note and I'm going to just block off the rest of the animals with that sticky note. So I'm going to use Memento ink to ink this up. Peel this off. So now when you stamp, you're only going to stamp down the rabbit. Make sure you have a big enough space here because you are going to cut this out with the circle framelits. So I'm going to use layering circle framelits to cut out my rabbit here. So I'm going to use the fifth one from the smallest. So I always count smallest in. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that's the circle I'm using to cut him out. What I'm doing here is I'm just coloring him in with the blender pens and the ink pads, powdered pink, sweet sugar plum, and smoky slate. So I've already colored in his whole body with powdered pink. So now I'm going to take the sweet sugar plum, and what you want to do is just give it a squeeze in the center, and then that will apply some ink down there for you to use. So what you want to do is, I use the powdered pink on the bunny, so I'm just going to run this over my scrap paper here just to run it clean. And then I'm going to pick up, I'm just going to color his ears with this, so I'm just going to pick some of this up and just color where I want to add this color. So like I said, I'm just going to color in his ears with the sweet sugar plum. And then his gray, again, you're gonna just kind of go back and forth with your blender pen until it runs clear. And then I'm just gonna use the smoky slate on his nose and his tail. Again, squeeze. So you want to just make sure you run your blender pen clear before you put it away. So I'm going to use the Thoughtful Banner stamp set. I want to stamp out this little hello on here. And I'm going to use Sweet Sugar Plum. You could use whatever you want. If you want to use your Happy Easter on here, you could do that also. I just thought it was cute with the little bunny. It looks like he's waving hello. So. And I'm just going to stamp this right in the center of here. Now I'm going to take my little stitch shape framelit here, and I'm going to just go around with the sweet sugar plum. We're just going to put this together. I'm going to use Stampin' Up! Dimensionals for my hello. And I put this up towards the top, right over my little ribbon. The little bunny, I'm just going to glue him flat down with some snail adhesive. And I kind of just angled him just on the front like that. You can turn it into an Easter card very simply. So I hope you guys enjoy. Thanks for watching.